It is possible to break the part of your brain that coordinates the movements of your muscles. Allow me to explain. For most people, moving a muscle is as simple as a thought. But for some, it is a stressful event that requires careful focus and multiple attempts. Think about all of the specific muscle movements that it takes to walk up to a door, grasp the doorknob with your fingers, twist just enough to one side, push the door open, and walk through. The muscles, large in your legs and small in your wrists, are working on specific coordinated tasks. Normally, you do not need to think about this at all beyond push or pull, because you have been well trained to execute these precise movements. But the parts of your brain responsible for sending those precise and coordinated orders to your muscles can be damaged, revealing the complexity of such tasks. Ataxia is the difficulty of coordinating muscle movements. It is the job of a conductor in your brain to make sure muscle movements happen in the order that they are supposed to happen, and with the intended intensity. Ataxia happens when that conductor is not doing its job properly. Getting your muscles to work together seamlessly is important for a large number of movements, but let's focus on just three big examples: your hands, your eyes, and your balance. Because your fingers do not contain muscles for movement, the fine motor movements of your fingers require careful coordination of the muscles located down in your palms and wrists. Coordinating this symphony of pulley systems requires careful conducting, which is why things like writing with a pencil and playing the piano take so much practice. A relatively huge portion of your brain is dedicated to these muscles, but without the conductor in charge of the careful integration of these signals, these fine movements become incredibly difficult. Your eyes also have quite a few muscles responsible for their movements. 6 different muscles control eye position, but because they are plugged into different cranial nerves, they can't directly communicate with each other. Instead, they send messages to and receive messages from your brain, where it is the conductor's job to calculate exactly when to send a signal for each muscle to act. If the coordination is wrong, the eyes will not look at what the person intended to look at. This can result in a person needing to make multiple eye movements in a row in order to fixate their gaze on an object. Your ability to balance and walk around is known as your gait. People with ataxia have an atypical gait and usually hold their legs wide apart while moving in order to assist their balance. This broad base helps to make up for the natural balance that comes from small, coordinated muscle movements. In 1897, a 30-year-old man described the progressive ataxia that he had been experiencing for about a decade. He described that he first noticed the problems in his gait, where he began to have trouble coordinating his walking. His boss thought he had been drinking due to how unusual his gait was. His coworkers complained that when he leaned on their desks while talking to them, his wobbling made them unable to work due to the unsteadiness. He began to notice difficulties in swallowing and speaking as time progressed, leading to choking hazards. He was unable to reach out quickly to grasp objects, and had to slowly and deliberately guide his hand to the object, and even then had to correct his reach by several inches. Interestingly, the coordination of his facial muscles was also affected, leading to uncoordinated facial expressions during conversations. Most of the problems in ataxia stem from the cerebellum. This is a part of the brain that contributes greatly to fine motor control, which is a way of saying small movements that work together with other small movements. A person might develop ataxia because of a stroke in the cerebellum, toxic levels of alcohol, or as a genetic disorder. The connection between alcohol and ataxia is especially interesting, because a person with the gait of ataxia may appear to be drunk due to the way they are walking. This is because alcohol affects the cerebellum in a similar way to how ataxia affects the cerebellum. Most of the time, effects of alcohol wear off, but continued use of alcohol can make changes to the cerebellum and the gait permanent. In many cases, ataxia can improve over time with rehabilitation that focuses on balance and coordination exercises. The key to making progress is regular intensive training, enough to convince the brain to rehire the conductor for the delicate symphony of moving your muscles. The next time that you tell your muscles what to do, keep in mind how tough that job really is, and this disruptive way that your brain can break.